Behold, the tapestry of destiny is unfurling before me, casting myself as the freshly anointed sovereign of an untamed realm, ripe with promise and uncharted greatness. I stand at the precipice of a grand odyssey, entrusted with the power to forge forth a thriving medieval domain that exists solely in the realm of my imagination. My dominion shall know prosperity beyond measure as I weave together the strands of resource management, population cultivation, and the symphony of unfolding narratives and challenges that traverse the breadth of the kingdom. A symphony of progress shall rise. An opus conducted by your very hands transformed this once uncharted expanse into a teeming metropolis. A testament to my vision and leadership. This is Foundation. Well, hello, my friends, and welcome to Foundation. Now, here's the map we're going with. I'm not going to mess about too much here. I'm just going to get straight in. I believe, is this a seed down here? That's a map code right there. So I'll zoom in for you on that one. We're going coastal, and this is the settings here. Let's crack on. So we're going to start game with no mods, and we're getting into it. All right, so those of you that know me, you will know that we are going for some kind of beauty here. So we're going to hear the advice at first. I've got a few hours in, so we've tested it. And I've purposely done it, so we've got a nice little lake we can kind of use. And I'm thinking, looking for some berries. I think this tile's not a bad starter one right here, actually. We've got a good amount of wood to go. Let's put this advice into practice. So what we're going to do is go through. But hello, guys, and welcome to the channel. I do appreciate you. I really, really do. We're going to go straight away with our village center. So if you haven't played this game, it is, there's quite a big scale city builder, actually. But it's relatively, let's say, laid back in its, well, at least from what I've played. So, all right. So next we've got organizing work. Then we're going to go in and get the builder's workshop. So we're going to keep these relatively, let's go over here for now. We'll start with a builder's workshop there. And what you need to do is actually, you can't paint it yet. So we'll get through this. So that's going to require a couple of builders. So what we'll do is max that out with builders so we can actually do stuff to start with. And we're going to go lumber camp. Now the lumber camp I'm going to have on the edge here. I'm going to get that one built. So that requires two tools. We start with 25, so that's fine. And then that means we can actually paint an extraction zone. So because we're building it in there, I'm actually going to paint the wood chopping zone over here. So we're going to go something like that to start with. That'll do. We've got to assign a woodcutter here, so I'm going to go in and I'm going to assign three people to that because we are going to need it. And then we're going to go into our next one here, which is going to be the forester camp. This one replants, and we've also got the gatherer. So let's put the gatherer right here. We're going to get that one to collect these berries, and we're also going to extract from that area right there. And reforestation, I'm going to try and match this whole area, so basically, anything they cut down in that area, they will replant, which is cool. All right, and in order for them to plant, we're going to need the forester's cabin, which we are going to get rid of these. We're going to build one forester camp, and I think we'll keep this relatively close, but we'll leave a little bit of a gap, so we'll go there, and we'll get that one built as well. You can prioritize with this button as well and get those kind of going, but we're not going to do that right now. We're just going to speed it up, watch them chopping away. Quite a beautiful game. It really is. I like the music as well. Very, very peaceful game. But there's some serious building you can do on it and decorating, which I think you guys that like Father's Frontier and stuff are really going to appreciate that, I think. All right, Gatherer's Hut is built. So we are just going to assign one to the berries for now. I'll tell you what, we do have the people to do two, so we're going to do that. And they should go and collect from here. There you go, because we set extraction. They're going to go and pick some berries in there. Oh, it's so beautiful, man. Yeah, as I say, I've played probably 5 hours on a playthrough or two just to get the basics down anyway, so I kind of just follow this. We'll dismiss that one, but we will put this one to use here, needs and happiness. So we now have a granary and a stonecutter's camp. Now, the granary is used for storing, so we are going to start by putting a granary store. The town hall's there. How do we want to place this? I think let's go a little bit of storage back here. Let's go there with the granary. We'll get our first one. We can't build that until we've got the stone cutters, though. So stone cutters, these have bad desirability. You see that red marker here? What we're going to do is actually try and move this over a little bit. So They'll create a path, so we'll just not be able to build houses there. Let's go there. And we'll continue on. What we'll do is set extraction from there as well. So you just need to paint the extraction on the stone. And just whilst all that's building, I will say to you guys, if this is something you want to continue, please do make it known. And please do smash a thumbs up as well. And if you are new around here, do consider subbing. All of that helps me determine whether I should do a series and continue on or not as well. So I do appreciate it. And as I was saying before, if you do have any tips on this game, please do feel free to put them in. Don't be obnoxious about it. A polite mention of it is fine by me. We are going to assign a couple of miners over. I actually need to reduce one or two down. So I'm going to take one out of the woodcutters and we're going to put one in the foresters. And that should start replanting. We'll just have to go with that for now, the two in the stone. And then once we've got the granary and stuff, we'll have people going through. But we need... Maybe I could reduce the builder down by one. But for now, that's fine. All right, if I look down here, then we've got a quest. It says, build a granary, assign a new transporter, and assign berries to the granary. That's fine. And we get 100 gold for success as well. Gold is quite hard early on until you have all the stuff set up. So it's important that it does get done. We're just waiting on a little bit of stone for that one. All right, the last stone has come in, so our builder's going to go over and get that one done. You can see the paths just slowly start etching out of the grass as well, so the builder walked over here to get this one built. It's really, really cool how the paths come out. The only downside I have is be careful where you place, because once paths are down, it doesn't let you build on top of them, I don't believe. It lets you build these, but the housing don't. So the housing are automatic, I'll show you. It'll make more sense, and they're the ones that don't build on top of it, and it can be a little bit frustrating. I think we're going to have to, although we need to accumulate, we're going to assign berries to this here. We need a person assigned to that. So for the time being, we're going to have to go down to one person on the stone. And we're going to get someone assigned to the granary here. There we go. And we can finish that one off. All right. The next advice is to buy a new territory and paint a residential zone. So here we go. I am going to build towards this because we're going to want fishing, right? So in order to get new territory, it's this little button down here. A pretty good piece over here, so we're going to go this one and then probably down into here. So let's purchase that one, and then what we can do is go ahead and start our first residential. So residential, you need to paint it, you get this red marker of desirability, and the wood choppers and the stone is no good for that. So we are probably going to try and do something like this. So I'm going to start with like a weird square shape thing here. But what I am going to do is also leave a bit in the middle, because I'm going to go ahead and build a market in the middle. Okay. So we're going to, I'll probably try and do something like that. So we'll do the first bit of housing. It'll make sense eventually, right? And then we'll get rid of that. So they'll start building housing around here eventually. But we'll need that market. So we're going to need that one. So the market's going to go in here. I'm just going to plonk that down. And what we want to do is go market stalls core, and we are going to get our first one in here. So I'm going to do kind of like a row of stalls here, and I am going to put a market tent on it because it looks nice. We're going to get that one built. And then what we'll do once that one is done, we'll assign the berries to that. And basically the market means they can distribute out to the housing. Quite cool. And then we're going to need a well. What we'll do, let's see this here. I think the well will be fine. I'll tell you what, with that little extra, we want two, don't we? So let's go a well here and a well kind of covering this area. So there's houses going up there. You can see them start to be built. So that's the automatic bit. Now, when the paths come through, the houses won't build on top of them. That's what you need to keep in mind. So it kind of does this natural build thing. It's very, very cool. There we go. Look, we got our first two houses up there. They're quite beautiful, actually. And obviously, these do upgrade as you go along as well. I can't say I've gone massively into the game. I only know the early on, so I am really excited to continue on and see how it does develop. One thing I do know is you need to be really careful with your money. Otherwise, it can spiral out of control early on as well. But yeah, there we have it. So we need to show zoning areas optional. Build a well, build a market, assign a new market tender, and assign berries to the market stall. Once that's built, we'll be able to do this type of thing. I'll probably have to go... you know what? Don't need that many builders. I'll be honest with you. Let's get someone assigned. We've got one there, so we'll have that ready for the market stall when they're done as well. Dates and stuff down here as well. Month 1, week 3, day 6. Obviously, coins, resources, villages, and happiness here. And then the types of buildings, ongoing construction, new workers assigned. There's villagers unemployed here as well, which is quite an important one. There's huge, like, trading stuff that you can do eventually as well. So to order, unlocking trade routes is your way of basically getting money. We'll get into that when it comes up as part of the starter quests. But there's our market stall, so we should be able to assign someone to that. And then we'll assign resource, so we'll go berries there. What will happen is they'll transfer from the granary here that we've got berries assigned over to the marketplace. Now, my understanding of the granaries is for every resource that you assign here, you do actually need a transporter to be optimum. So that's how I kind of play it at the moment. There we go. Our first well is in as well, so that should be this. So what we need to do is raise the happiness of your village to 75, currently 15. Now, the only way to do that is to actually... There's a... I believe the recreational. I don't know if we're there yet, actually. What I'll do is go into the book here, and we'll go into progression. And what you can do is unlock certain things. So this costs 25 gold to unlock for decorative as a warehouse. So you've got stages, and you've got this progression thing here. So prosperity, based on territory, population, wealth, commerce, splendor, and beautification to unlock the next phases. And it gets quite costly. And you have different types of paths when you get there as well. But we are going to go ahead and unlock the decorative so we can purely go in and pop down a couple of nice things. So we've got our first well in. I think by the well, it's always nice. Or by each house, actually, you can put in fences. You can decorate around. I'm actually going to go ahead and put flowers there. I'm going to come out of that one. And these have eight an area. So these guys obviously need to be within the zone. So you've got the benches as well. So what I like to do near the marketplace is what we'll do is get a couple of benches along these paths they've created, because I do quite like how it naturally creates them, and it means that house will get a little bit of a happiness boost. We'll get that one built there as well, and then we'll get in a couple of trees and bushes around this area. Right, we'll get a tree that covers both of those, so that'll be quite nice. It will grow up eventually, which is always good. And then we'll let the time play, and I'll get a couple of flowers down on the corner this way as well. Let's see if that does enough. We're on 45% already, so that should continue to go up. All right, our first monthly report is in. So quests 100, 102 on construction. So we actually down money. That's fine, though. We've still got 423 coins to work with. We're 5% away, so I don't know. I think once we'll wait for this one to be completed, and I think that will boost the last bit up, I'll be honest. Let's just see. There you have it there. The paths are coming 73% there. Look, they do start to carve out, and the housing estate does start to look quite nice. You need to keep in mind that you will need to keep this update. But we are officially on 75%, so that does mean we'll be hitting some immigration here, which is nice. And there you go. If you look somewhere on the map, they do come in, and we're relatively close to it, actually. So we've got two new people coming in, which is going to be fantastic. And we will be able to unlock certain things on our Book of Fun over here. So fishing, butchering, wooden bridge, and a warehouse. Use for storing and trading resources. We are probably going to need that. So, yeah, I'm going to unlock that in anticipation. We will need it at some point. And what you need to do is accept them. So we'll accept them both in. Profiting from trade. Here we go. So advice is to build a warehouse, which we just unlocked. So it's a good job I knew that, eh? We've got sawmill where you can make planks as well. We're not going to... Although, is that required? Yes, planks are required for this one. So sawmill, bad desirability. We are going to bring this in... I want to keep, like, the woodworking, a little bit of a woodworking area, you know. We've got the builder's hut, we've got the two lots of wood there. So we are going to go, yeah, we're going to go right in there with our sawmill. And then what we'll do is get the warehouse ready as well. So I'm going to put the red ring on this one. That isn't a bad one, by the way. I'm going to put the warehouse near this as well. So we've got a little bit of a storage section near the town hall thing here. It doesn't really matter too much because the traders walk towards it anyway. But we'll get that one in, and we'll make sure this one is set as priority from the builder. You see how they're starting to make a weird path here as they start to build? A little bit frustrating, but I'm not sure. It looks like the houses are going on top of that path, so maybe they've changed that. And same over here, actually, so that's fine then, if that is the case. Those houses disappeared, but I think, are they going to upgrade? Yeah, house density 2. You see how this is house density 1 and then house tier 1? These are being changed into house density 2, which is cool. So they're going to be a little bit bigger, same with that one. So we'll wait for those to be built, and you can kind of see what they're all about as well. And with these new people in, we are going to have to... Let's get a third person in the woodcutter, because you're going to need loads of that. And we've got some more people coming here as well, which is fantastic. I'm going to make sure we are up to speed. Now, you have this. Now we've got that up. You have an immigration factor here based on happiness. Now, our food, apparently, is a bit naff. So we will need to get another one in. I don't think it is, though. I think we'll just have to deal with that. And there we go. We've got those houses kind of upgraded. That's all one house, actually, isn't it? Yes, it is. It's got like a little shed. There you go. That is one house. And there's the other one. So much bigger. Nicer looking. It's got a weird ladder on the side, but it's very cool. And we'll accept these guys in as well. It's more mouths to feed, but it's okay. And I'm going to just slow it down a second. And we'll just wait for this sawmill. But what I'm going to do whilst that's going, actually, let's go into here. We can't unlock this yet. We'd have to unlock the zone, but I definitely want to fish. Wooden bridge is not needed yet. And then the butchering. The reason why I'd want to unlock these, if I go into resources here and you go trade routes, actually, it would make sense to get meat first, because we can sell that to the trader and make some gold, right? The second trader is a fish one. Yeah, so we could sell berries, you can sell polished stone, we're not onto that one. So planks are something we can buy and sell. So what you need to do when the trade is ready is you need to go into the planks, and you've got the buy until, or the sell all above the value. So what I like to do is make sure we do have some planks in stock, and then we sell all above the value. So they'll always sell the planks when they're above 20 for now, and we can do that. And we can also do the same for the berries at, say, I don't know, for now we can go 75, and then we'll set up those to sell above 75. They're the only things we're kind of making at the moment that we can sell to these guys. So you're looking at this kind of thing here. We're only producing the berries and planks to be able to do that. We can buy in if we need from them as well. Sometimes it's good to buy the cloth in. But based on that, it might be a good idea to go into the butchering. So you only need serfs, so the lower common people. We're going to unlock that. And we're going to go into that. I know it's still waiting on the advice, but we'll have that ready. I won't put it in just yet, but we'll keep it good to go. And there's hunting zones. So if you go click the hunting zone, it shows up with where pigs can be or the boar. So it might make sense for us. It looks like this zone here is going to be the best for that, which is good. As you can see, though, our sawmill has completed. So we are going to go ahead and get two people in there. And we may need another lumber camp at some point, but we don't have anywhere to store it. So what we're going to do now, the planks are done, is we are going to make sure that the warehouse is good, and then we can store logs to that, because they can only store a maximum of 50 inside of the lumber camp. So you're going to need this warehouse to select the store in there as well. And there's some more people coming in, which is kind of good. It's also a little bit scary, but they go and wait at your town hall to be chosen for the town. We'll take them early on anyway, because we are going to need them, and that does mean we can basically max out whatever we need. Those guys are okay. Oh, you can select the type of tree if you want to go for one look as well. I just leave them all for now. We can get more carpenters in potentially, or we can get another transporter when we've got the pigs. I think because we have the spare people, just going to slow it down. We are going to go into the butchery, which does require planks, but we do have the tools. But we need the hunter's hut first, don't we? That will produce the boar. So, hunter's hut. Where do we want you? To be fair, it kind of makes sense to have it near the food here, but then you paint where they hunt. So we'll build it there, and we'll allow that one to go as well. So in between, they'll get the logs. Get those guys producing. So we're waiting on a bit of stone there. So in the meantime, then we can get a couple of miners in with the spare population. So we can see over here who's unemployed. So we've just employed our last two into there. We'll get them grabbing in a bit more stone so we can increase that one. If you're wondering about the map as well, so I tried to keep it relatively flat. So late game, we'll be building down towards this, and we'll make this kind of like a nice area on the beach, because I'm pretty sure you can go down that route as well. It's kind of why we wanted to be up in the hills. go from there. I'm not even sure if there's... I know you can build an army, so there's some type of combat. I don't know whether you get attacked or whatever. You'll have to let me know on that one. I don't mind. But yeah. We're still on 75% happiness. I purposely try and save the money, because you do need a fair bit of it. You need it to, like, unlock certain things, so... Yeah. Right, we got 5 stone in there, 8 planks, so we still need that to do its thing. Let's get a third. We can't go in there anyway, so we'll just leave that. We'll wait. All right, in the meantime, though, the hunter's hut was built, so because that took that. So we've got one hunter that we can start going. We've got 2 people come in, so we are then going to grab those hunters in. And what I'm going to do is go into the tab here, and we are actually going to create... So what you can do is just paint everywhere, really, where you think the hunt might be. These pigs do move around, so I'm just going to paint this whole tree area. For now, we'll go with that. And in all fairness, we could reforest a bit more. So we can go kind of paint the reforest there. Although you can't see it, it is here. We'll get all that reforested there. If you're wondering, you can go visibility. You can check zoning areas. You can tick in here as well. Territory. You can remove that one. I am going to remove that. You can do minerals, so if you need to find certain minerals, turn that on and off as well. You see how this changed? You got a big patch of stone over here. Fertility, obviously, for the good old the farm stuff. And then desirability. Desirability is an important one, so the greener the better, right? And then overlay tooltip. Alright, the warehouse is finally being built, so I can show you what this is all about. We can overstore now, which is good. And there we have it. Warehouse number 1 is built. So I'm going to assign certain resources. So we're going to assign planks to that, because you need to assign it to here in order for them to be sold. We're going to assign wood, and we're going to assign stone. And I'm going to get, when I can, more transporters in there. We'll just assign that for now, though, and you'll see they start to store up the planks and things from these when they're full, and they take them over there. All right, planning trade routes added. So basically, unlock a trade route to trade planks. We've already set up that, as we said before. So what will happen is other faction traders will walk down. As you can see, their path started here. That's where they come from. And they'll basically walk up to where they can buy stuff from. Yeah, all right, we got our first lot of boars in. There you go. We got more population coming as well. So we have 4 boars. And with the people coming in, what we can do is go in. So I'm going to click the food production tab. It's a lot easier. We are going to need a butcher here. That's something we can sell. Not sure if this gives bad desirability, actually. So if I click this... Where do we want our butchers to be? I feel like I want a new zone for production, but I do want to bring housing down here. I also don't want to go into my trees. I don't mind going up into here. That's outside our territory, though. So for the time being, I think what we'll do is go... We'll just have to go housing across, I think. We've got enough space for that at the moment. I'm going to bring this a new section here then, and we are going to go ahead. It's not polished stone, so we're going to go ahead and build this butcher's here. And we'll get that assigned. So in order to do new food as well, you also need to build more market stores. So what you can do is go into the edit building, and you can basically add new market stores to the same one. That's what we'll do. Let's turn off the desirability here, and let's accept these guys in. And let's make sure we can work with these guys. So, going to get another transporter in. You see this? So we've got stone, wood, and planks now in here. What we want to do is we're basically waiting for a trader to finish this one up. But in the meantime, we can go in and see if there's anything we want to do or buy a new territory. We can plan our housing. So what I'm going to do is actually plan a little bit more housing. The market's good there. I don't know. I think we could basically just extend this one out. I'm going to do this. And make this a little bit bigger. Something like that. So we're at the edge here of where we can go. For the time being, we'll do that then. And I'm not going to go any further down, so we're leaving that. It doesn't have to be perfect. And well, when we unlock this one, it'll make sense, I guess, there. We're not going to go any further, I guess, than that zone. So let's just do that for now, so I kind of know. I'm not sure on the range of these guys, actually, as well. If I go into desirability... I don't think the marketplace adds to it, it's the other bits, actually. But what we're going to do in anticipation of getting the food done, I am going to go ahead then and get another market stall in. So we're going to try and get this one the same. So, he stood that way. So what we want to do then is get this in line. Boom, and I am going to get... I'm going to use up our cloth here and get that one in as well. And you can decorate around these with common decoration. This all gets more and more in-depth as you go along as well. And we are going to hit build and get our second marketplace. Once that's built, you get another slot here, so you can add another worker and then a second thing here. So one of them can only hold 30 berries here as well. 3 consumed per week, or 4 consumed. So you have a little consumption rate based on the market as well as how you need to expand it. But we're going to be putting meat in there when it's built. But it's a bad desirability building. And I think the Hunter's Hut is a bad one as well. I don't know why, but it is. All right, we are going to go ahead and assign certain resources now across to there. We're only going to go with meat, actually. I'm going to get a second transporter on there. Pigs will obviously be slaughtered anyway. I've noticed that a 1-to-1 ratio on this, so the pigs will always be kind of around that area. We've got 2 new people coming in as well. And market stall, I'm going to prioritize. Oh my god, 4. So we're going to accept these guys in. We're obviously very happy over here. And that gives us a lot of people to work with, actually. So we could get another builder in. We can get another sawmill if we want. But if we do that, I think we're going to need another lumber mill. So I'm going to leave that one. Berries are good. Don't ever do more than 1, by the way. They'll run out of berries. I've done that before. So I'm going to go in and we're going to hit resource and we're going to get another lumber camp on the go. So where can we fit this one? I don't want it to be too messy, but I think at the same time, right there is perfect. So we're going to get that one built with the tools that we've got. We're not producing those yet, worth remembering. And you see this? So our coin tendency right now, we're going to open our budget this month. Upkeep is 3, so we can tax our people, by the way. Never a nice thing to do early on, but we can do that. But we can't do it until we've built our manor house. That'll all come soon. All right, the butchery has been built. I'm going to go ahead and get 2 in there, and we're going to see how this produces now. We've got the boar healer. So all they do is produce meat. And then we've also got the other market stalls. So we're going to get a second person in there, and we are going to assign the meat. So the more they have, obviously, the more happiness they have. And the higher you promote them, the more needs they have as well. A little bit similar to how Anno, as they get promoted, they have more needs. Way more laid back than that, though. But there we have it, guys. That is going to be our episode 1, finishing off on the beautiful foundation. I hope you enjoyed. And if you did, please smash that thumbs up for me. If you are new around here, consider subbing. And let me know your thoughts on the game as well. And if you want to support me that little bit extra, do consider becoming a member of the channel as well. It helps me continue. As always though, guys, take it easy and I will see you in the next video.